I'll wait. I pray to the Lord, my soul to take, my soul to take, my soul to take, my soul to take. Hey, get on your job, little man. This ain't Saturday.
Realizes like the monetary, the material, even the success, and like the things that you put your, you place your importance on, never can satisfy you and ever make you happy, because they never end. There's never, you can never, there's no amount of money that will ever make you stop. If money is what you care about, you'll keep going. Oh, I got a million, gotta get 10, got 10, gotta get 100, got 100, gotta get 5, got 5, gotta get a billion. If it's cars, you'll never have enough cars. If it's women, you'll never have enough. You'll be chasing them forever. If it's success, you can never get enough of that. I realize that. It's like, it doesn't stop. It keeps calling you. It's like a drug.
It's a hamster wheel.
It's a hamster wheel. Mm-hmm. And it's like, you're never satisfied. But if you place your importance on this, appreciation, love, you know, it's like that, that is enough. Mm. There's enough of that in everybody's life right now if they just took the time to look.
Good, y'all. I'm gonna do a little bit of a different video today. Welcome back to another YouTube video. It's your boy Dominic Round, aka Mr. Rise and Shine. I don't even know what to call y'all yet. Just, I'm gonna call y'all my family. I know everyone, like all these YouTubers have these cool names, like what's up my peoples, what's up, blah, blah. But like, we're kind of different, you feel me? Like, we're, the brand is called Rise and Shine Lifestyle. But I can't call you like my shiners, I can't call you my risers, so I'm just gonna call y'all my family. So welcome back, my family, to another YouTube video. We're going to do a recap of this week and how everything went. it's been a very interesting week, to say the least. It's been a lot of ups and downs, but let me start back to last Saturday is when we first started recording, and here it is. Different spot today. We are actually at the Pit in Hillsboro, North Carolina. So it's kind of close to Durham if you guys are familiar with that area. We're on my Raleigh, North Carolina peeps. But yeah, this is a really dope gym. I'm actually about to squat.
Here in the corner, some mirrors. They have a lot of dope equipment. There's Merlin on this bar, though, man. We're about to go to war today because this thing is sharp. Up over there. And then we got Dr. Tank over here about to do what she does best.
It's gonna be a good little workout. We're on week 3, which means we have a heavy double on both squat and deadlift. You guys already know the vibe, so let's get the mind right. Let's go in here and execute.
Stop the count!
Saturday. Last Saturday. I didn't know what day it was, but man, I went in there. I was like, hype. Going with squat some. And I went in there. I was focused and tunnel vision. That was such a trash workout.
Man, all I was thinking about in my head was, I could do this, you can do it. Put your hands down and pull it through it. Yeah. Oh, it's heavy. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna pass out.
I was like, I thought, I done saw Jesus a few times, man. I was squatting, I was like, let's get it. And then like, man, my body was just saying no. Your boy actually tried to make it up, so I hit 570 on squats. It was supposed to be for a 7. That wasn't a 7, bro. That first one, I was like, yeah, let's get it. And then, as you can tell on the second one, I was like,
deal, help me, help me.
Save that, man. I had a dope spotter. Shout out to the owner of that gym that we went to called The Pit. You appreciate you, man, because you saved me from dying that day. I was like, you know what, cool. I told Marcellus, like, bloop, bloop. I was like, Marcellus, bro, I overshot. He was like, bro, why? A mistake, and I've really just learned to be like, well, why am I doing this? Like, why do I have these moments of overshooting? And I think I'm just putting too much emphasis or value on a number, and that causes me to overexceed what I should be doing that day, thinking that I have to push myself to a certain extent to make progress. When progress, it's all about working smarter, right? Not harder always. So 551 took my butt out. Like, I picked that thing up and I was like, picked it up and I was like, turn off the camera. I told my girlfriend, I was like, turn off the camera, we're going home. I am done for the day. And I never do that. So to all my peoples who may see that and be like, what? Why would you go home? Like, you can still finish out the workout. Sometimes, like I tell all my clients, you have to live to lift another day. And then for a minute, bro, I didn't pick up the camera. It was like 4 days. I was depressed. I was sitting in my house. It's like, this should be fun. I should be having fun making progress with lifting. It's just lifting weights. And I was just like, let me get my mind right. And then I went in and I actually worked out at my job, Crunch Fitness, and I had a really awesome deadlift day. Yeah, 5:45. For a spicy, kind of paused, but I paused at 9, didn't I?
That's cap.
Why didn't you record it?
You cap.
Top set of 4. I was like, ooh. That was dope. Had some good energy there at Crunch. And then I was like on my Bobby Flay, Guy Fieri, like I was chopping it up. I was like, I'm going to cook something. Well, I'm gonna grill something.
It's the ultimate throwdown.
Oh yeah. And that's what I did. I incorporated a lot of grilling in my meal preps, and it's been helping out so much. The food tastes better. It's easier, in my opinion, just to cook it all at once. And I just been having fun. Like, you feel me? I've been getting my like stepdad, like uncle on, just at the cookout. I've been growing a lot. So I wanted to showcase my little cooking skills here and there. You know, I ain't a chef, but your boy can throw down. Your boy can throw down. Yeah, what's good, everybody? It's been a week. It's been a day. We out here. We inside, chilling. Hey, real quick, I actually have to do a podcast. I have a podcast with Gymnast United Incorporation, or Inc. It's a black-owned National Women's Gymnast League that offers gymnastic competitions, mental health counseling, and injury rehabilitation. So this is owned by Tamil Jones. I'm so sorry if I butchered your name. But I met her at the North Carolina State Championships, and she actually offered to have me on the podcast that she has. So I'm really excited for that. Cannot wait. That's going to be in maybe about 30 minutes.
We're going to take just like a 10-second recording just to make sure you sound okay. And put our sponsors in, and then we'll continue.
Okay.
Introduce you. Your last name is Rowden, correct?
Rowden.
Rowden.
Yes.
I wanted to make sure I pronounced that. Thank you so much for coming on. This is going to be great.
Thank you so much for having me. And then we did a podcast, Ripcast. Shout out to Tamil Jones. She had me on there as a guest, and I'm so honored. It was incredible. All right. I'm gonna go up to 496. This is kind of where I see where I'm at today. Not always, but most of the time. I have a number in mind of what I want to hit, but the main goal today is to hit, and if it's not there, don't force it, you know? I'm gonna have a good mindset when it comes to squat. I want to push something nice today. A little bit less than what I did last week, so, but yeah.
It's gonna be 700.
Ooh, whoa.
He's like,
oh. But I think right now I'm just gonna try to, you know, see how this feels and then move on from there. But about to put 496 in the bar. Let's get to it.
Keep my dick on. Shout out, man.
All right, we just hit 562 for our top double. No, you get, you get out. So everything's feeling pretty good. I definitely think that was a good call for today. A little bit less than what I did last week. Got a little ambitious, and I just was too taxed to really maintain the intensity that I wanted. And it's okay. You know, you're not gonna always go balls to the wall, and that's a hard lesson I've been having to learn, because you're not gonna be strong all year round. Do I wanna hit crazy numbers? Of course, but I'm gonna build into that and make sure that it's, you know, I'm one healthy and it's sustainable strength. So dialed it back, gonna knock out these back downs, and then I'm gonna try to hit something really spicy for deadlifts, since deadlifts never fail. Had an amazing workout because we stayed true, we kept it conservative on squat, and we pulled a PR on deadlift. Wow. Wow. Imagine, right? Whenever you follow the program, it works. That is dope. So, had a long talk with Marcellus, and he was just like, you know, reassuring, and we just had a good talk about, like, take what's there, man. What I always preach to you guys, gotta preach to myself. What do they say? Do as I say, not as I do. And had an amazing workout on Saturday. Couldn't ask for anything better. Saturday and Sunday, we hit 336 on bench.
Hey. I woke up feeling like I was on crack. I don't know.
I love that, man.
I woke up probably the best I've slept in like a year.
Right on, that's awesome.
My Fitbit was like, you got 90% recovery last night. I'm like, oh, shit.
It was pretty good, pretty smooth, trying to incorporate more leg drive, but it was overall a good week. You couldn't ask for anything better. It was very different, and I had fun, and I learned a lot along the way. I see new things coming out for Rise and Shine, and our peoples over at Palmetto State Barbell came through with the care package and some Carolina Primetime shirts from the meet, and just some goodie bags. So shout out to you, Marshall, and your wife. I thought I was gonna get robbed, but a whole bunch of cool stuff this week, man. I was going to get more footage, but I decided just to give y'all like a little commentary of 2 weeks and just maybe start doing this more often. If you guys like it, let me know in the comments down below. But yeah, that's pretty much what happened. We learned a lot of lessons. We hit some cool PRs. We saw some cool peoples at the gym. We cooked some food. Cool stuff for the business. And we just did our thing this week. Yeah, that we rise by lifting others. Anything is possible if you set your mind to it. Get around good people. Love yourself. Do the right thing. And rise and shine to a new day. Love you guys. Your boy Diamond Brown. And I will catch you guys in the next one. Don't know when it's going to be, but we're going to post that when it's done. Take care, y'all.